Well, hello chaps, it's Commodore Grayum here, and welcome back to TerraFirmaCraft Reloaded, as played by me. Now then, we managed to get back with a whole... Well, I was going to say a whole buttload of cassiterite, that's a complete lie. We managed to get back with sufficient cassiterite to make 11 tools, I suppose. Which is quite a lot, so let's get busy in that regard. We need a bunch of straw. So, great. We have plenty of logs and things. We've got some torches to set light to this stuff. So what tools and or weapons would we actually like to have? Clearly, we already have a prospector's pick. It doesn't matter that it's copper. The copper saws, that's fine too. I think I want to make a bronze axe and mace. So, let's see if we can remember how to do this. The axe is easy enough, of course. Huzzah! Did I already have one of those? I did. Nice one, Commodore. We could try making a sword as well. Ah, why not? So we'll make one of these. We might as well bake this mold whilst we're at it, because we'll use it at some point. Hammer. I want a bronze hammer. Maybe I want bronze all the things. So let's set about it. Let's see. Axe, hammer, sword, mace. That's what I'd like. Boop, 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 boop. The mace mold, where the hell is it? Aha! Okay, that's easy enough. So, I've got a crushing weapon here, and it does a lot of damage, but it swings very slowly. Well, not too badly, but let's get ourselves a bronze mace, nevertheless. What else would be a fine plan? Oh, this seems to be some... Is this a piercing sword? A poignard. Poignard? Poignard. That's probably how you pronounce it, isn't it? So, let's also make ourselves a bronze knife. So that'll be like... Scythes, I'm not really sure quite yet what you use those for. It's probably something incredibly important. We want a pick, of course. Okay, I'm not carrying enough clay, seemingly. We can easily sort that out. So you would be like this, Mr. Pick, would you not? Okay, let's pop through here, see if there's anything else. So what do we have? We currently have 5 things to cook. Do we want any more? We don't need any ceramic vessels right now. Probably. I mean, although it may be the sort of thing where it never really hurts to have one. Bolt. I guess that's for crossbows. And we should probably make a bronze hammer. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, that's easy enough. Whoop. I said that's easy enough. It's easy enough if you remember that it's inverted. So we're going to have to make these molds first, I suppose. So what else? What else? A rod. What is the rod even for? I wonder. Oh, arrows, eh? Hmm. I wonder if these break every time you cast arrowheads, or if it's a little more lenient than that. We probably want a shovel. So that would be like so. And then we want an empty ceramic vessel to put the actual metals in. So how many things are we making here? One, two. Oh wait, we already have a hammer mold. Whoops. So let's put that to one side. Let's put the extra axe to one side, because we already have an axe mold. Wait, what am I saying? No, we're only carrying one axe mold right at the moment. So this is eight things. So that's 800. Do we have 800? 25 units each. So that's 400, 800, minus one. From each. Oh, I'm getting so confused here. So the cassiterite is 10 units. And we're making 8 tools. So we need 8 pieces of cassiterite. That's 80 units. Dang it. So what we have in here is in total 800 units. 800. And 100 per. So if we get rid of a couple here. Oh, is it like this? We may have some left over here. Hopefully I've done this correctly. So we're going to have 900 units. Well, no, we're not going to quite have 900 units, but we're going to have the correct ratios of things, because we've got 800 and then 80. So that's 1 in 10. Oh, wait, no. Let's drop a couple of these. No, drop 3 of them. My apologies to anyone who's currently screaming at the screen because of my terrible mental arithmetic. Okay. It's been a while since I've had to do any, in my defense. Okay, great. So, now a bunch of logs, and we should probably use willow, really. What we should probably do is eat some food. And the mutton, as per last episode, keeps leaving my hotbar for no apparent reason. That's enough for that. Oh, we already had some logs on us, actually. Never mind. Okay, fine. Less fine. And now, drop one of these on here. Wait, what? Oh, I picked it up again. Whoops. And one on there. And I suppose we'll be able to make all the things in 8 in-game hours, hopefully. I really hope I haven't messed up the proportions. I probably haven't. We're probably going to get bronze out of this. There's a range of proportions that will work. You don't have to be completely exact. So whilst we're waiting for that, let's go and check out some other stuff. We have a bunch of soybeans that have finished growing. Right. Going to quickly make myself a shovel, actually. Because I want to make some new farmland. I'm assuming that... Okay, you have to let farmland lie fallow for a while. After you've used it, in order for it not to lose fertility. I just had my sounds up a bit too high on my end. I could barely hear myself talk. Just fix that. Yeah, and I'm guessing that letting it lie fallow basically just means letting the grass grow over it again, or maybe it means leaving it for a season. Right. Let's think. How should we do this? Well, firstly, we're going to need a hole, so let's get ourselves one of those. I've probably got one in my shack, but oh, bugger. Ah! God damn it. But we can just easily make one out of this gabbro that we have on us. Right. So this will work for a start. So what I'm going to do is, since these soybeans have all matured, how many seeds did we get out of that? Oh, only 7. Oh, I guess we'd only planted 7 or something, so that's fair enough. So there's all of that planted, and we have a whole load of soybeans. Awesome. Now, what next? I guess I could... Whoops, I could dig into here. How many was that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's probably about as far as I can go. But that's completely fine. That'll do the job nicely. I'll keep it separated from this farmland that we had already. Just so that I don't get confused about what I have and haven't used. Right, that's probably... That will probably do us for a while. Whoopsie-daisy. Now then. This barley is not quite ready, but it's not going to be long. So we'll have a bunch more stuff to feed the cows. And we'll be able to make some barley bread as well, of course. Sugar cane's continuing. Takes quite a long time, unfortunately. Making a little garden in front of my house here. Cute, I know. Right. So, not long to go. It's kind of exciting. So I'm wondering what I should do next. I mean, oh, I know. We should feed the cows and we should milk the cows. Actually, we only need one more bucket of milk. We'll get two anyway. Hold on. 2, 3, 4. Whoops-a-daisy. Not sure what I was doing there. And let's put our buckets down in here too. Right. There you go. And... Whoops. It's pregnant. This cow is pregnant. This cow does not give milk. The Oh, my word. Can I not get milk anymore? Because pregnant. Is that how it works? Hmm. I mean, that's fine, that's fine. We'll just make a little bit less cheese than I thought we were going to. So we'll use this bucket to grab the vinegar. Right. Fantastic. So do I leave this in here? No, I don't. Seal it. And I'll get curdled milk, which I believe you can then turn into cheese by just leaving it in here for longer. Is that how it is? I'm not really quite sure. We'll figure it out, I'm certain. Right. So, let's put away, actually, let's grab all of our foodstuffs and check them for spoilage. Yeah, that's probably a good idea to fix that every so often. What's in this? These go off. These grain doesn't go off. Fine. So now if I... There we go. I should have chopped the decay off everything there, I think. So. What do we have here? Cannon. We have a whole bunch of rum here. I'd love to have a barrel of... This didn't work, did it? I tried it last time. God damn it. See, I need more fruit to put in here, and it all needs to be of the same kind. I need 20 ounces, and I don't quite have it. Ah! Curses. Oh! Right, oh shit. We're carrying too many things. Let's put all this stuff away. So this can be for fruit and the... Oh. That didn't work. Fruit and whoops. And my remaining barley. That can go in here, I guess. That makes sense. Now. Ah, bollocks. Okay, let's just get everything put away as well as we are able. Because we need to get out there and deal with our tool situation before all of that bronze solidifies. Yeah, that'll probably do. So, 805 units of bronze. Great. Okay, we're good. Everything's going to be fine. All right, let's get indoors, lest any disaster befalls us. It probably won't, but let's start making tools. So, we want an axe. That's for certain. Ah, so exciting. A pick. Bronze knife. Entering the Bronze Age, finally. Yep, hammer, for sure. Mace. This is great. Shovel. Oh, and a sword as well. We're going to have all the things. And, oh, wait. Oh, halberd. We could make a halberd. Because we have an axe mold. And we already have a bronze axe. And we have a hammer mold. But we already have a hammer here. I could make another axe, though. That's probably more sensible, because we'll get through that. Chopping down trees. The copper axe, well, obviously it lasted a lot longer than the stone varieties, but not all that long. Okay. Ah! Breaking the mold. Quite literally. This is amazing. So many things. Put the spare hammer mold away. How good is our bronze mace? 220 damage. Oh, that's nearly as much as this. Wait, can I put this on the tool thing? Yeah, I can. Fantastic. So that does nearly as much damage as the warhammer, except it can be swung far more quickly. Oh, this is amazing. Okay, I'll put all my spare stuff on the tool rack. How much damage does this sword do? 220 again. So I'm going to keep my two main weapons on the one and three slots. And no, 2 and 3. And I'll put the axe right here. So let's make ourselves one of these. Oh, right. This does quite a lot less damage than the sword does. So it's a good thing that we made the sword as well. So between the sword and the mace, we're getting pretty formidable. Although we don't currently have any armor, unfortunately. Let's put our spare bronze axe here. Oh. Okay, that was weird. Bronze hammer we're not using right now, so let's put that away. Maybe we should make another tool rack, actually. This one doesn't match, but never mind. Even our knife does a fair amount of damage, and it's piercing damage. Maybe I should have made a bronze javelin just to see what it was like. Oh well, never mind. The knife we're not really going to be using for combat particularly. And finally, our pickaxe. Ah, so good. Right. We need to have some noms. Yeah. Well, that's about it for noms. Yeah, that makes sense. Grab ourselves. What should we grab ourselves? We're lacking in grain and dairy right now. Should I make some bread? Yeah, I'm going to make some rye bread. Why not, indeed? I guess I'm going to grind all of this rye. Why not? Need an empty hand for this, I think. Oh, missed. Why didn't that work? Is it shift? Okay. Now we need a water bucket. Maybe one of these out here has water in it. No! Lovely. Bunch of door. Light this. Okay, done. And we have bread on its way. So we have a tiny bit of solidified bronze in here. I guess we'll put that in there. We're going to have to, at some point, go and get ourselves some more tetrahedrite from our mine. Let's put any spare tools away we don't require right now. Fantastic. Okay. Keep an eye on the bread. Okay. I'm going to cook it till it's medium, I suppose. It is just my way. Oh, wait. Do we need some more fuel here? Maybe we do. Right. There's that sorted. Can we eat it yet? No, it's too hot. Oh. No. Just takes longer to eat it when it's hot, I guess. I can't wait to use these new weapons out on the mobs. Going to completely wreck face. Lovely. So maybe it's a good time to head out to the tetrahedrite mine. Right now. Make ourselves a bunch of supports. That's probably enough for now. I'm going to make another tool rack whilst I'm at it so I don't have to worry about doing it any other time. Oh, it won't go there. Fine. Now, what do I need to take with me? Clearly I don't need to take the prospector's pick because I already know where everything is to be found. Don't need this, or this, or this. Or that. What went here? The mace. So I've got water, food, etc., etc. Got all the things. Can I put this away? I can. I'll take these extra supports just in case. And actually, I should just quickly check how long we've been recording. Okay. Not quite half an hour. It always seems to be around half an hour when I check. I clearly have some sort of built-in timer. So our bushes aren't producing anything just now. Should I take some more logs? I'll take a few. And what time of day is it? Pretty early. These crops are probably mature, so before we leave, we'll check up on that. No. Not quite yet. Oh, you know what we should take? We should take some empty ceramic vessels to put the tetrahedrite ore in. 1, 2, 3. We're not going to need more than 4 of them, are we? Well, 4 is what we have. Oh, by the way, how's this doing? We got cheese. Oh my word. Okay. So, I guess we can get our dairy score up, so to speak. I'm not going to eat that just yet. Oh, and you know what? Before I go, one of my viewers had the rather bright idea. That'll do. Of lighting the way to my mine, and especially across the fords that I made with jack-o'-lanterns so that I can find them. I think there's a bridge right here, isn't there? Yeah. So let's use our shovel. First shovel usage, very exciting. Right. And let's just keep heading straight north, I think. Put one down here, perhaps. Yep. And then one bang in the middle of that bridge. And I think if we take a left, yeah, this is where we'll find our mine. Brilliant. Okay, let's... Ouch. Let's be a little more careful, perhaps. Okay. So, we should be able to just start hacking away at this tetrahedrite right here without anything collapsing. This pick is certainly quicker, it seems. Okay, fine. Ah, brilliant. So each of these, how much are we getting? We're getting a lot, I think. So if I don't want this to collapse, I'll have to start, say, here. Lovely. Right. So we have, what, 9 pieces so far? Not bad, not bad. Ooh, whoops. Now let's see, where is this? I guess I can take this down. Yeah. That was unnerving. Nothing really actually seemed to happen, though. This is too low down. Well, is it, though? I think I should be able to take this out. Yeah. Oh, no. That was not the right way to do it. Okay. We should be able to take this one out because it's only one block above the supports. I believe this is how it works. And, oh, wait. This is 2 blocks above the supports. Okay, so if I... Oh, wait. Let's get out our... shovel. We're not really using... we're not really using the knife down here. Now, should be able to do this. Basically, you don't want to start any cave-ins, which means that you have to start digging within one block height of the mine support. And the cave-in protection will go like up to 4 blocks away from the horizontal beam, I think. So... Oh god! Well, I clearly don't understand this as well as I would like. Whoops-a-daisy. Okay, so we need to deal with that water, I guess. But we should be able to take these out. None of my supports collapsed. Okay. So we can block this with a log. That'll do the trick. Now what? Well, that didn't really Ah, that didn't really exactly work, did it? Why can't I place this? Help? Did that stop it? No. How odd. Okay, fine. Now then. Let's make ourselves a support. I guess it would have to be... This is really derpy the way I'm doing this. I am fully aware. So I should be able to take this out now. Lovely. But not that one, necessarily. I could take this out. Yeah, I clearly don't understand this properly. Okay, so we seem to be running short on ore anyway. So let's run back home. If we happen across any enemies, we'll be a lot better equipped to deal with them than before. Uh-oh. Don't shoot me. Oh, wow. That was fantastic. I liked that a lot. So, well, we don't really need to make any more tools right now, but when we do need to, we've probably scavenged most of the tetrahedrite we can from that particular deposit. Turns out we didn't need these after all. That's fine. Put away the mine supports, the lumber. I guess blocks go in here. Guess that's how it is. And we almost lost our ability to run on the way back, actually. So you can see our maximum health going up there because we're improving our dairy bar with the yummy, yummy cheese of goodness. This has ended up in the wrong place. Fine. And now... Oh, I guess we picked up a bunch of quartzite rock because we were mining. Let's put away... I guess the jack-o'-lanterns should go in this one, technically. What do I mean, technically? Jesus. We probably need... Oh, wait. We probably need some more torches, given that we have a single torch. That's fine. So, a certain amount of progress has been made. I'm sure you'll agree. We have cheese. We have pregnant cows. Which, I mean, that's kind of exciting. We'll be able to get far more... dairy next year, I suppose. I guess it's going to take quite a while for the calves to gestate inside their mother's wombs. I'd really like some more fruit so we can do something with this rum. If we can just get up to having 20 ounces of something. So we still need to start doing stuff with the anvil and the forge, but it just hasn't been necessary yet. But that's what we'll need to get to the next tier of things. I mean, aside from anything else. Oh, let's get some experience. Oh, wow. That's awesome. Your maximum health goes up as you gain experience levels as well, I believe. So, we have this stone anvil here. The next tier, of course, would be copper. But the trouble is that we don't have flux, and you need flux to make double ingots in order to make the next tier of anvil, which, of course, is copper as well. Wow. And this sword is going to last a while. What if I was doing critical hits? I should be able to one-shot these fools. Let's find some. Oh, hello. Oh, amazing. Okay, and if I do critical hits, that will, of course, save durability on the sword as well. What would be good is if I could hunt down some of those skeletons that have armor on and just beat them to death with the bronze mace. Beat them to double death with the bronze mace. Get some of that armor back. But probably the next thing we should do is head back over sort of yonder to where we died to the bear and pick up all the stuff that we got, because we picked up a load of crops, a load of fruit, I think, probably. We need to get all that stuff back. Plus, we left a bunch of tools over there. Although they are copper tools, it's always nice to have spares. I think that's basically going to be it for now. I think that's going to be the episode. Hope you enjoyed it, ladies and gentlemen. If you did, do please click the like button. It helps out rather a lot. Share this video with anyone you think might be interested or entertained. Ooh, you're a tough one. Leave your thoughts and suggestions in the comments section below and subscribe if, but only if, you'd like to see more. Ta-ta for now, chaps.